No doubt that cybersecurity is one of the biggest issues facing companies and individuals worldwide. Twice already this year, companies have been brought to their knees by ransomware attacks. Behind these kinds of attacks are hackers, and police and intelligence agencies are using good hackers to fight the bad ones. Our next guest is paid to do exactly that. Trishneet Arora, also known as the Ethical Hacker, is in Delhi for us. Thanks so much for joining us. Can you tell me exactly what you do?
Hi, thanks for the introduction. So we are legal hackers and friendly hackers. So who help the enterprise customers and as well the government agencies, all over the globe. So to hack into their systems ethically, so we can penetrate into their security systems and find out the vulnerability stacks, and they can patch those vulnerabilities, before any fraudulent hacker can use them adversely. So this is the short, in a short description, I can talk about me and about myself and about my team.
Can you explain for us who you work for?
So we are working for government agencies all over the world. So almost 6 to 7 countries government is one of our client, and we are working for one of the top Fortune 500 companies all over the world. And we are also working here in India with law enforcement agencies, and we are also working with a lot of financial institutions here in India and Singapore as well.
Are you looking into crime in particular, or are you looking, into cyber crime by other governments and state agencies, or are you looking into terror threats, or a mixture of everything?
So yes, we look into the cyber crimes. If the cyber crime is already, has taken a place in a company or either with an individual. So we take these, the step ahead, and we have a specialized service which is called TechCert, Cyber Emergency Response Team, where we help the enterprises, to figure it out who exactly, breached their system and how it happened. So, it should not happen in the future. At the same time, we also help the law enforcement agencies. If any cyber terrorism, cyber attack has taken a place, and so we help them to find out the culprit as well. So this is how we do.
And how do you do this ethically? I mean, do you have to get government permission to do this in all the countries that you work?
Yes, so we are working officially with various governments. So some of the governments has taken us on the board, and we also help them to take the make the cybersecurity policies for them, and formalize the cybersecurity team as well to fight for next if World War III happens. So I personally believe the World War III will happen through cyber. It will be cyber war. So a lot of governments are already proactive about this, and they are taking measures about it, and they are formalizing the policies, and at the same time they are also formalizing the cyber team of cybersecurity experts that who can fight against cybercrime.
Okay, I mean, warning of World War III as being a cyber war, that is a pretty alarming fear for all of us. Can you elaborate?
Yeah, of course. So as of now, a lot of cyber, the crimes are happening. These are data theft or either the financial loss. Now, obviously, the cyber crimes are also harming the reputation of a company. For example, if any company gets breached today, so their, market cap will go down 22-27%, in a week or so. So this has been said by various reports. So, now in the future, the IoT is coming, and then, medical devices are also getting connected with internet, IoT. So our, personal life, human life will be gonna dependent on the technology. And the same time, if technology is there, obviously vulnerabilities are also there. So in next couple of, you know, years, you will see, you know, the rather than the financial loss or the data loss, the life, human life will be gone on risk.
Can I just ask you, just finally, I mean, you, I think you dropped out of school, is that right? Because, I mean, all of us try and stop our children using tech too much, and yet you've made this incredible career. Just, you know, what happened to you? Why did you get so interested in hacking?
So I was always, you know, since my childhood, I was also, you know, always curious about how this technology works, even though, you know, my parents used to bring, you know, electronic toy at home. So, I play with that for a couple of minutes or, you know, maximum, you know, an hour. So after that, I just try to open it, you know, how does it work? So, you know, the how that technology works. So same thing happened with, you know, computer. My father bought a computer home. And, you know, I played a couple of games in that for good 2-3 days. Then afterwards, you know, I was curious, how does it work? So I opened it, but, you know, I was having no knowledge about this. So, you know, I couldn't fix it. So I couldn't, fix that. So we went to a computer shop where we have bought it. So he fixed it, that computer hardware expert has fixed it. And I seen him, how does it work? So I came back and started doing it. This how this happened eventually. So, you know, I was little, I won't say that perfect, but yes, I was, you know, at the age of 9 or 10, I was aware of how to, you know, fix the computer hardware problem.
Okay.
And my neighbors and my relatives used to invite me to fix their computer problems at the age of 9 or 10.
Okay,
so
well,
that is begin, yeah.
That is incredible story. I'm sorry we're out of time. It's fascinating speaking to you, and I'm sure we'll be speaking to you again. But for now, Trishneet Arora, thank you so much.